I go through, like a lot of people do, I go through the Market Smith 250, which always seems to have 300 stocks in there. I don't know why. They should change the name. And I go through that. I look, you know, those, that's, it's a great screen to get through, because you're looking at some of the best stocks that have the characteristics that we're looking for.
David, how do you sort this when you start looking at it? Do you just go in alphabetical order,
No,
or do you?
I always go in group rank because I
Okay.
want to see the best stocks in the best groups. And I just go to group ranking. I hit right there. You got number one, and I go through there. And you know, when you see them in group rank, then you can see how many names are in that group. You can see what's happening to the group. When you look through all those solar stocks, and all those solar stocks are going, you know, they're going straight up, it's telling me it's probably getting late in that group. But I love to see them all within the same group. And then I also, you know, then I also, as we mentioned last time I was on, I like to go through, you know, industry groups to see what industry groups are moving up. That's another screen. I have kudos to Mark Minervini. He put that screen out there talking about where the 200-day moving average moves up for the first time in for a month. What is it? Oh, it's called the trend template.
Yeah, the trend template. Yep, we have the 1 month and the 5 month.
Yeah, the 1 month, I spend a lot of, I go through the 1 month because the interesting thing about the 1 month, which is great, is because you're seeing stocks that had been either in a downtrend or been going sideways for the longest time. And then all of a sudden, the 200-day starts moving up for the first time for a month.
Yeah.
That's, and what I like about that is that what that it does is I don't want to be looking for stocks on their lows. I want to see that first move up and then the drift off and then the next and then get the other move. And that's where I think I found a lot of those fertilizer stocks and you're seeing, and a lot of the oil and gas stocks, you're seeing that actually happen where you get that first move up and then and I'm looking at price and volume, and when I'm see, and when I look at that first move up, I'm looking in how many days are up. Has it had a 3 week period of time where there was just buying after buying after buying, and then the next for the next few weeks or next few months it goes quiet on the volume as it drifts back down. And
So, Arusha, where
yeah,
is the
the easiest
Minervini?
way to find it is go to the open stock ideas button
Oh, sure.
and
I always
go
forget
go
that.
to the weekly review and scroll down. There's the 5 month. Click on 5 month. And now when you look in the lower left-hand side, you might need to no, you know, raise the bottom panel up again, Chris.
Okay.
And it's going to open up to the 5 month, and then right below it will be the 1 month. Oh, right above it's right 1 month. There you go.
1 month.
So
Okay.
you go through the 1 month, and you can sort it. You can sort it any way you want. I mean, group rank or current price. I mean, sometimes I actually even look at lower price stocks. I mean, not the $1 and $2, but the you know, three, four, and five. I mean, some of the moves off those. That's where I picked up Nautilus last year. It showed up on this. The trend template, and I mean, this stock had a gigantic move. But you see, you know, and there's a lot of junk down there below 10.
Right.
But you actually see some pretty interesting percentage move gains on some of those names. But it's also good for higher price name too. I mean, areas that haven't done well, and then start turning higher. I always have a list. I call it because I worked at you know at the company for so long. You would get something. I don't know if they still have it. They have something called a data monitor in the institutional department, where every week you would get a book of the stocks that you like the most, and you know, it's you can just form your own list, and every week, or even a few times a week, I'm going through that list of names that I've highlighted, and I just drop into my list, and it's kind of my watch list. I probably have a little over 100 names in that to go through just to see, because, you know, something I find, hey, that looks kind of interesting, but it's not ready yet. And I drop it into that list. And 2 weeks later, it shows up and I go, hey, that's ready to go. And then I set my alerts.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching Investors Business Daily on YouTube. If you want to watch more videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a thing.